Good morning, friends. So today we are going to discuss about limit of a sequence. Limit of a sequence. So the definition for limit of a sequence is something like this. Let us consider Sn be a sequence of real numbers. Sn approaches to L as n tends to infinity if for every epsilon positive there exists a stage n0 belongs to natural number such that for every n greater than or equal to n0, distance between Sn minus L should be less than epsilon. Okay. So, this essentially means Sn approaches to L. So, this is the limit of a sequence. So, when do we say that Sn approaches to L? If given for every epsilon positive, this is some radius. Okay. So, this is a very base and foundation for convergence of a sequence. So, if you are strong enough in limit of a sequence, then convergence of a sequence will be very easy. For every epsilon positive, there exists some stage n0 belongs to natural number. So after n greater than or after this stage, your sequence should follow a definite condition that Sn minus L should be less than epsilon. Okay, so this is a very important statement of a convergence of a sequence. Okay. So if you take your sequence Sn to be some 1 by n. So 1 by n, if we expand, this is 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3 and so on. Correct. So this is your S1, this is your S2, this is your S3 and so on. So this in your line, it will be like this. It will be converging to 0. Correct. So 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3. So this will be like this. So if you draw any neighborhood, the distance between Sn minus L, if you give any epsilon positive, you have to find some stage. After that stage, all your Sn, after that some stage, your n0 may be 3, whatever it may be, depends upon your epsilon. So that should be less than that of your epsilon. Then you say the sequence is convergent. So let me, sorry, then you say this L is limit of the sequence. This L is limit of a sequence. So let me give some example for better understanding. So this essentially means after n naught. Correct. So d Sn naught comma L should be less than epsilon. D Sn naught plus 1. Correct. Comma L less than epsilon. So on. It should be like that. So let me give some examples. Sn equal to 1 by n, epsilon is equal to 0.5, and for this same epsilon is equal to 1 by 10, for this same epsilon is equal to 1 by 1000. So the question is, find n naught such that Sn minus L less than my epsilon. This is what we have to find. Correct. So this is a question. Now how do you find the solution? Very simple. What is my Sn? 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3 and so on. As n approaches to infinity, 1 by n will be 1 by infinity, which is 0. So everybody knows that the limit of this sequence is 0. So what we have to say, distance between 1 by n minus L should be less than epsilon. So this here my epsilon is 0.5 for every n greater than or equal to n naught. So we have to find this n naught. After which n naught, this condition holds. After that n naught, my infinitely many terms of my sequence should satisfy this condition. So that is very, very important. After some finite terms, my sequence should follow a this condition. My sequence should hold this condition, then I say the L is limit of my sequence. Okay. So here how will you find 1 by n modulus 1 by n only less than 0.5 can be written as 5 by 10. Correct. So 5 by 10. This is nothing but 1 by 2. So if you put n is equal to 1, 1 less than 1 by 2. So is this true? No. Correct. So if you put your n is equal to 2, 1 by 2 less than 1 by 2. This is also not meaningless. If you put your n is equal to 3, 1 by 3 less than 1 by 2. This is correct. This is correct because 3 greater than 2, 1 by 3 less than 1 by 2. So this is correct. So I have chosen n naught to be 3. Correct. So my n naught is 3. So after 3, n greater than or equal to 3, 1 by n minus 0 less than 0.5. So this is the stage after third term. After third term, 1 by 2, 1 by 3 and so on, converging to 0. After this, this is my S1, this is my S2. So from third term onwards, if you draw any open ball around this, open ball of 0.5, the distance between 1 by 3 minus 0, that is less than 0.5, and 1 by 4 minus 0, less than 0.5, and so on, infinitely many terms up to 1 by n minus 0, less than 0.5. So this is the condition of convergence of a sequence. So for the same question, we have asked 1 by 10 and 1 by 1000, correct? So this is very easy to find, I think so. So 1 by 10. So Sn is equal to 1 by n. 1 by n minus 0 less than 1 by 10. So 1 by n less than 1 by 10 for every n greater than or equal to n. So what is this n naught? Now if you put 1 by 10 is less than 1 by 10, is not meaningless. So 1 by 11 less than 1 by 10. So for every n greater than or equal to 11. Or you can directly say from this n greater than 10. Correct? So after 10, that is if you are writing like strictly greater than, it will be 10. Greater than or equal to follows as it will be 11. From 11th term onwards, the sequence satisfies this condition for this particular epsilon. So in the same way, if I give my epsilon to be 1 by 1000, 1 by n minus 0 less than 1 by 1000, so n should be greater than 1000. So my n naught I can choose is to be 1001. Okay, you cannot choose 1000.1. Why? My n naught belongs to natural number and hence this is valid. Correct? So I would like to give some more examples to understand limit of sequence. Okay? Yes. Sn is equal to, okay, some oscillatory sequence. Let us choose. So this is all about limit of a sequence and so now Sn goes to 0 if Sn is equal to 1 by n. This all we know. Correct? This is very obvious fact. But how can we prove by limit of a sequence? So if Sn converges to L, that is goes to L, then for every epsilon positive, there is a stage n naught belongs to natural number. such that Sn minus L less than epsilon for every n greater than or equal to n. Okay, so this is a statement. So this is P implies Q. What is contrapositive of the statement? Negation Q implies negation P. Correct. So how can you say, what is the negation of this statement? Let me write it with another ink. Okay. Alright, let me choose the red color. Negation of the statement. There exists some epsilon positive such that for every epsilon positive, there exists epsilon positive for all n belongs to natural number. So this is a negation of the statement. So what does this say? Sn converges to L if for every epsilon positive there is a state such that Sn minus L less than epsilon for every n greater than or equal to n. What is the negation of the statement? Sn does not converge to L if. So here I have highlighted the there exists in for all, because the negation of for all is there exists. Negation of there exists is for all. Okay, that is what I have written here. So I just double here. Okay. So Sn does not converge to L if for every epsilon, if there exists some epsilon positive for all n belongs to natural number such that there exists some n greater than or equal to n, and this condition violates. Okay, so then we can say Sn does not converge to L. So today is all about limit of a sequence. So we have seen an example with how a limit of a sequence look like. So this is all for today. But tomorrow I'll explain you about convergence of a sequence, which is very 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 similar to that of limit of a sequence. So that limit of a sequence requires lot of practice. Only then convergence of a sequence will be easy for you. So tomorrow I'll try to explain convergence. Like and share the video with your friends. Thank you for watching.